was good, y'all.
Zachary McMoney Mowing. So this video, three parts. First part, I was mowing about 2 weeks ago. I'm meaning to do this, but it's been 2 weeks since I posted the video, so I'm putting it here now. I was mowing in a neighborhood I always mow in, and when I got out of my truck, there was a little kid over yonder staring at me, and I felt weird at first because he was staring at me intently. But then when I got out, he said, "Are you Zach?" And I said, "Yes." And then he was like, "I watch all your videos." I was like, "Oh yeah, I have YouTube videos all over the place." So he said he watches all my videos, and he had a skateboard in his hand because he knows I skateboard. And I was like, "Do a kickflip, I'll put you in my video." So I put him in my video, and his name is Eli. I believe he's 8 years old. He mows 8 yards in his neighborhood. His dad drives him and his electric mower to each house, and he was just super cool, and I'm gonna put him in my video. That's the first part. Second part, I'm gonna teach you how to create powerful energy, the energy that you see in all my videos. I'm gonna show you how I create it using music. That's part number two. Part number three is I'm gonna show you how to make a delicious 800 calorie or more meal for whenever you're mowing 10 yards a day and you're tired. You need to fuel your body. So I'm gonna show you how I break my fast every morning. It's gonna be eggs, spinach, and a crazy healthy oatmeal with all these ingredients like flax seeds, chia seeds. And that's how I maintain a clear complexion, and I have all this energy to do all these things that I'm doing. So first part, skateboarding. Second part, music. Third part is me showing you how to make a healthy meal that will fuel your mows. So without further ado, let's get it going. Bet. You gotta land it. I land it after you. Nah, you gotta kickflip it. I'm not letting you give up. That's a high ollie. I'll fast forward all the kickflip attempts.
Oh, there's so much pressure.
There's no pressure. How do you think I feel when I'm filming videos? Now you know how it feels to be a YouTuber.
Alright, for the video.
Oh. Here, film me doing one, and then you give me back.
Hey! Oh, the big spin!
Do a clean one, I'll give you 20 bucks.
For real?
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
One more clean one, come on. You know you can do clean. The money's waiting for you.
Ooh.
You got it?
I need that 20 bucks.
Do you need it for what? What are you gonna buy, candy?
No.
Damn. You need 20 bucks, I need to finish my work day.
No.
Big breath, take time.
This is awesome, I watch all your videos.
For real, you're the first one who's ever came up to me and told me that. If I wasn't here, would you have landed it already?
Yes. Is there another trick for the 20 bucks?
No, that's a kickflip. You can't, that's a lesson. You can't give up. You can do it. It just takes time.
That's
that
count.
I count it.
Yes, let's go. Put that in the video.
Are you landing it?
Mhm. Let's go. Thank you.
Yeah. Say make money mowing.
Have a good day. Make money mowing, guys. Subscribe.
All right. What's your name?
Eli.
Butter.
Guys, you have to be the energy that you want to receive. You have to create the energy in order to receive it back. And if you want to know one of the ways that I like to do it, what I do is I turn on music really loud and I headbang by myself. And whenever I'm done, my ears are ringing, my adrenaline's pumping, and I feel 10 feet tall and strong as an ox. So I will show you, as example, how to do this.
Motherfucker, I'm gonna go to San Antonio.
So we're making up for lost time, since it took me 2 weeks to post my last video. And even though I posted a 35-minute video yesterday, and probably most of you haven't watched it, I'm gonna post another video because I got this apartment, not for me to live in. I don't mind living at my parents. I'm an only child and they have 2 bedrooms in their house. And by living with them, I can drive my mom around because her eyesight's not that good. I can help them around the house and I can give my mom money to put towards her mortgage versus me giving it to a landlord. But I got this apartment so I could film videos in peace without distractions from my parents and my chickens. So we're gonna post another video right now. I'm gonna share with y'all how to eat properly to fuel your body for 10 Mo's a day. I'm gonna share with you my first meal of the day. It's about 1 p.m. I'm about to eat fat, so let me show you. Step one, scramble chicken eggs. Throw spinach with coconut oil, salt, pepper, and get it cooking. Turkey bacon, healthy turkey bacon, not the cheap stuff. That's the proteins and fats. Over here, we have our oatmeal. Oats, almond milk, chia seed, hemp heart, flax seed, I sweeten it with maple syrup 100%, and then I throw this in there for extra calories and fats. And then she's right here, she's about to take a microwave bath. You could stovetop it, but I don't do that. Step two, make the eggs and spinach have a baby together. And then flip this with the other hand. Just like that, bam. Still getting used to this oven. All I use is black pepper and that pink salt. I made an omelet on accident because I was filming and I messed up, but we want this scrambled. Okay, I'm gonna try and do this with one hand. I feel like a Neanderthal. This is hard. Now, here's the fun part. Almond milk, oatmeal, that's already done. Throw in some chia seeds. I usually use a spoon, but we're hype right now. Boom, chia seeds. A little bit more. They got omega-3s. You don't need fish oil supplements. I used to buy them every month for like 10 years, but you could just get it from food and it's more bioavailable. See, omega-3s. Hemp seeds, these have a lot of protein. They don't taste like anything. All three of these don't, well, this one kind of tastes like nutty, but these two don't taste like anything. Okay. Bear with me, my fellow brethren. Damn, I'm just making a horrible mess. I think my bacon's burning, but it's all good. Okay, whatever. Maple syrup, nah, we'll do that last. Should have opened all these first. Pumpkin seeds, boom. These got a lot of iron in them and they're healthy fats. If you're skinny, like I used to be, well, I'm still kind of skinny. Nuts and seeds have a lot of calories for you to get your energy from. Walnuts, just savage right now. Boom. Got some raspberries of whatever else you want to put into them, boom. I'm OCD, I don't want this touching the bottom of the fridge because it's sticky. Oops, that was fast. Okay, so that's that. Get our spoon. Boom, look at that. That is probably more nutrients in this little bowl of oatmeal than the whole day of me eating before when I was just a Neanderthal, just eating meat and protein and rice and stuff. So that's that. Here is the scrambled eggs. It's just spinach, eggs, salt, pepper, and coconut oil. Coconut oil doesn't taste like coconuts really, and it's healthy for you. You could use olive oil too. And then here's the bacon. I'm gonna just drip all over my house. No, I'm not, because there's not really lots of fat. Bam. That looks funny. Okay, boom. Look at that. This is how you mow 10 yards a day. Just like that. I've tried being vegan before. I did it for a couple months. I felt good, but it was just not manageable for just my daily life and just the things I want to do and the traveling that I do. I felt all right with it, but I mean, eating eggs that are healthy and eating the most expensive bacon you could get that's quality and eating stuff like this, I feel good, and I don't think the best diet for you is on Google or for someone to tell you. I think it's up to you to do different diets, eat lots of carbs, eat low carbs, eat all fats, eat no fats, go vegan, go paleo, just eat regular. Just do whatever feels best for you and don't do what other people tell you to do because everybody's body is different. If I could just share one thing I've learned from all the times I've been working out and following diets is there's no one best diet. Just eat as healthy as possible. Whenever you eat something, just try to make it have one ingredient, ideally. So what I mean by one ingredient is, this is all the stuff that I put into my oatmeal, right? These chia seeds, what are the ingredients? Let's check. The one ingredient is chia seeds. These walnuts, what's the ingredient? It's walnuts. So just try to eat like this as much as possible. Ingredients, it's just hemp seeds. Like stuff like this, if you look at the ingredients, it has a bunch of random stuff that you can't pronounce. So maybe this isn't ideal. Maybe I can get a better almond milk, but you don't have to be perfect 100% of the time, but just like, look, 90%. Everything else is just one ingredient. My maple syrup. What's inside of it? Let's check. Where's the ingredients? I don't know. I guess it's because it's 100% maple syrup, then there's no ingredients. It's just maple syrup. This flaxseed right here. Ingredients, where you at? It's just flaxseed. Let's see what else we have. The oatmeal. Did I show this already? Okay, one more thing. This bread right here. Sprouted bread. It has more than one, but look, organic sprouted whole grain, wheat kernels, organic raisins, gluten, wheat gluten, which is the protein, yeast. So this is like, okay, but I wouldn't eat this every day, but it's better than the other breads. This applesauce, this is a good example. You can get the shit that has all kinds of ingredients, but look, unsweetened applesauce, what's inside of it? It's just manzanas. So that's what I mean by just trying to eat one ingredient as much as possible. Also, one more update. So to talk about my course real quick, what I did was about 3 weeks ago, I put it live for the first time and it was awesome. I got a bunch of good feedback from it and it was helping a lot of people because I put my actual Craigslist ads, I put how I put myself at the top of my Google listing for my area. I shared how to legalize yourself, how I did it. So all the information's there, but maybe I'm just a perfectionist and I just wanted to make it even better. So I closed it so I could make it better and I've been working on it and I've updated some of it, but I haven't updated all of it. But maybe, again, I'm just a perfectionist, but people have been asking me when is it gonna go live. And the reason that I took it down is because I want to focus on maximum value, just not maximum money, or else I just would have had it sold for this whole entire time versus closing it and saying no to money, basically, because people are trying to buy it. So what I'll do now, because everybody keeps asking me when it's going to be open and they want it now because they want to use my ad and they want to start making money, is I'll just put it open right now again, and it has the updated videos, and I'm still going to continue updating the whole thing. And whenever I finish updating the whole thing, then I'll just put a notification that the whole thing is updated. But if you buy it right now, then you have access to all the updates. You don't get charged anymore because I just switch out the videos for the new updated videos. So if you buy it now, then you have access forever to the course, the updates, and you can comment inside of it. And I'm always checking the comments every single night. On YouTube, I get hundreds of comments a day and I try to get to everybody. But with the course, it's locked in and every night before I go to bed, I check that and I reply to every single person for all the questions that you have. So with that being said, I'm just gonna post this little meal video and that's the update for the course. So by the time you watch this, it will be live, and if you want it, cool. If you don't want it, cool. Either way, I still love you and I hope you love me, and I'm gonna eat my food now because I'm so hungry. Also, just to show that sometimes we don't always get what we want, yesterday I deadlifted 315 and that's a new max for me, so I'll put a clip of it, and I got it. But today I tried to bench 225 and I didn't get it. I failed and nobody helped me. I could have got a spotter, but I don't want to ask people to spot me. So I just let it drop and I was hoping somebody would come help me because people are all around me, but nobody helped me. So I guess this is me showing a failure. And also, this is how you fix yourself if you bench and you don't have a spotter and you fail. This is how you get it off of your body without decapitating yourself. Okay, I'm out. Thank you guys. Love you.